for a way to acquire high-demand accelerators and structure your machine learning jobs cost-effectively? In today's video, we'll tackle these objectives using the open-source Kueue project with an example implementation using Google Cloud and the Dynamic Workload Scheduler. We aim to familiarize you with the open-source Kueue concepts, which build on standard Kubernetes. However, some Google Kubernetes Engine specifics will also come into play. Now imagine having different workloads that you want to handle efficiently, like model training with PyTorch, TensorFlow, or Ray. The goal here is to run these jobs so they're scheduled to maximize cloud accelerator availability and cost efficiency, whether that's Google Cloud TPUs or traditional Nvidia GPUs. To do this, we'll employ a game-changing approach that flexibility aligns capacity with job requests using Kueue. We'll break down the specific implementation and benefits in more detail during the hands-on demo. Let's get started with precisely that by heading to the Kubernetes Engine service in a new Google Cloud project and constructing a cluster. It suggests using an autopilot approach, however, we'll opt for the low-level control of standard clusters. Although the defaults mostly get the job done, we'll want to tweak a few things. For example, we'll increase the node resources, but cut down the node pool count with E2 standard 4 machines. Also, we'll need Kubernetes version 1.28 or later for the system to work. However, for the benefit of those working with existing clusters, we'll go with the default 1.27 and then show how to do the upgrade afterwards. To make the Kueue installation process hassle-free, we'll use the Cloud Shell. Once the cluster is settled, we'll just need to use the installation command from the README. This will, of course, require that we are first authenticated with the cluster. Now, back to meeting the minimum Kubernetes requirements for this setup, let's upgrade our control plane and node pools to v1.28. We're now all set with the cluster and able to run that kubectl command. This will install the Kueue system from the associated GitHub repository, including a number of resources, primarily in the Kueue system namespace. Importantly, we'll also get the Kueue controller manager deployment. Next, we need to set up some systems for tracking and managing our jobs. This part involves some YAML, but the Cloud Shell editor will make that a breeze. We'll create a repository for this work, and we'll post all code in the video description. Let's open up that new repository in our IDE before we start. One of our first tasks, constructing a queuing system and configuration. With a bit of code borrowed from a Google Cloud example repo, we introduce these queues for managing resource requests and, specifically, NVIDIA GPUs. Think of these queues as the mechanism by which the jobs are held pending, as required, The job requirements are coordinated with the cloud provider, and the provisioning requests are coupled with the workloads. Specifically, the local queue elevates namespace-level workload resources to cluster-level provisioning work. A provisioning request configuration and resource flavor gives some structure to the patterns by which we'll run jobs. Kueue thrives in heterogeneous cluster environments. For example, we have both performance-boosting GPU nodes along with your everyday standard nodes in this cluster. The configurations here provide some structure around how jobs are ran against those heterogeneous resources. Next up, we need a job to run. That's where our example repo steps in again. We've got a job lined up in there which requests one GPU and runs a sleep operation. While this is a standard Kubernetes job, the Dynamic Workload Scheduler system can also work with native Ray, Kubeflow, Flux, and PyTorch resources. One last step before we can run this, we need a Kueue-compatible node pool. Time for a little help from our friend, the Google Cloud documentation. For cost savings and rapid provisioning, we'll opt for Nvidia T4s. Again, though, this system will coordinate with Google Cloud to get your desired accelerator type and desired accelerator quantity based on the ability to leverage flexible scheduling for capacity alignment. So feel free to request something more interesting here, like H100s, if your project quotas and budgets allow. We'll opt for the latest driver and cap our provisioning at 10 nodes. We'll need to tweak the new lines here to avoid syntax issues. Oh, and remember to specify a custom machine type. We're going for non-default N1 Standard 4 machines since they'll work with our NVIDIA T4 GPUs. The most important piece of this configuration is the Enable Kueue Provisioning flag, which marks the node pool as being controlled by provisioning requests, for example via Kueue, and dynamic capacity planning. Now it's finally time to apply our job. Checking in with our local queue, we note our waiting workload, but no major events. We could further poke around the various events and logs to check things out, but know that we're still one speed bump away from our workload scheduling and execution. Specifically, we need to enable an additional feature that connects Kueue with the Google Kubernetes Engine autoscaler. Update the deployment in the Kueue namespace to adopt the Provisioning ACC feature. This is a straightforward addition to the container arguments. Want to add this feature through a Helm-based installation or by tinkering with the YAML file that we leveraged earlier? You can do that too. But we're choosing the fast lane. A quick edit operation will work just fine. Once the edit operation is complete, we need to check on our pods in the Kueue namespace. We're looking for a fresh new pod. A quick inspection shows that everything is on track. Now, checking back on our submission, it's already in the admitted category. Again, we'll go through our resource events and controller logs to see if and where we might have any last issues. This is an important skill to develop, as the Kueue system relies heavily on the standard Kubernetes systems and abstractions. It looks like we've mislabeled our node pool. Simple fix. Tweak the example configuration to accurately reflect our actual pool name, NVIDIA T4s. Delete the old job and apply the new one. This should once again create an associated workload. Let's describe the workload to check the progress so far. This was passed up from our local queue in the default namespace and accepted by our cluster queue. We should now see a provisioning request tied to this workload. Indeed, it's looking good with the status of accepted but unprovisioned. We haven't run the job yet, but we're going to wait until the full requested Google Cloud capacity defined through this provisioning request is available and allocated. Again, we could have jobs that demand multiple GPUs, in which case we're going to wait until that full capacity is available, no expensive partial fulfillment. All right, it seems that about a minute ago, the capacity did indeed become available, and we're now running our job. Of course, there won't be many logs here since we're simply running a sleep command in the pod, but we have successfully ran the provisioning work. Let's take a look back at our T4 node pool now. Eventually, of course, our job will complete. Then our GPU node pool will scale back down to the zero. We could have ran this entire system without Kueue, so let's make things crystal clear and summarize why Kueue is beneficial here. First off, we're improving the ability to obtain accelerators, since Google Cloud has more flexibility and clarity around accelerator requests. Notably, the time flexibility means that Google can plan our capacity requests, rather than treating them as now or never. Accelerator requests can include TPUs as well as GPUs like A100s and H100s. We're only going to use this system for batch type work, given the potentially large weight for high demand accelerators. The second major advantage is avoiding partial fulfillment of capacity requirements. If we need 4 TPUs, for example, we want them all at the same time to avoid paying for idle accelerators. We hope that this video was helpful and we'll provide the demonstrated code and diagram in the video description. Thank you very much for watching and please enjoy responsibly.